Hello and welcome. And next I'd like to show you that how to do this Honda Civic cars, this front brakes lubrication, and how to check that all of these Honda's brake pads and they are moving well, and so how to lubricate well this front brake system. And then we continue. And first step is to take this wheel away and lift up this car body a little bit up. Okay, and now I have take this wheel and tire away, and next step is to take my hands in here in that position and in that position, and then I need to rotate in that way this disc in this kind of position. And there is now idea that when we are in that position, we can easily open these bolts in here in that way. And now I notice that this my brake fluid bleeding bolts cover was away, and now I inserted this back, and now I am planning to open that one and that one bolt, and these bolts are 12, 1, 2 millimeters, but there is thing that these bolts, they are tight and difficult to open if we are using so small tool, and that's we need longer tool. And now I have in here longer, and what longer tool, then the more force. And now when I insert that my tool in there, in that way, it is easy to only rotate in that direction. This is this opening direction. Look, now when it's open, there is this one socket, and now I can rotate it easily. And this is this circle, in what way these bolts open. And here is then this lower bolt, and I have in here this little bit bigger tool, and this bar length is something like, this is like, there is 1 feet, 1.5 feet, or in metrics 50 centimeters. And when I use this long tool, every bolt opens. Look in here. Now I open that, and this opens also very easily, that bolt. Okay, good. Then I take and I rotate that in that way, and then I have my next step is to take this bolts away, this lower and then this upper, and there are these bolts 12 millimeter, and then this upper one in here I take also that out, and now those bolts are here, and then I need to take this brake caliper out. And in this Honda model, it can be quite tight, that we have difficulties to open it, and for that job I need next this big flat screwdriver, and I need that kind of, this is heavy duty model flat, and then when I insert that my screwdriver in these holes in here, and especially that point and that, I can bend that in this way, and now it actually moves, and then I can move, bend this also in that way, that I insert my tool in this position, and then I bend that, and then this caliper opens. Okay, now when we are in that position, I can take my hands and use gloves, because these are rusty and very dirty. And then I lift that my caliper in here in upper one, that up position. It is, I took that in here, and then I insert it in here. This is a nice place. Okay, and then next step is that there are those brake pads. Okay, and then I start to take these brake pads away, and normally they are quite tight, and for that job I need again this flat screwdriver, and idea is now that when I insert that in this hole, in that way I can bend that my tool in this way, and then when there is this hole I can insert the tool, and in here I can also use little bit hammer in that way. Let's look. When I try to take that, here is this my hammer tool, and I insert that in just in, there is this brake disc and this brake pad, just this joint, and then couple of hammering carefully, and then this tool, it is in just in there between of those brake pad and brake disc, and then idea is that I insert this my tool in that way, and then I move that in side by side, and then I press same time in deeper, and then when I do in that way, you can see that this pad moves, and an idea that first in that area, and then up and down and up and down, and then when I move that, finally it opens, and I little bit press in that direction. Finally, this is the final hit, and then brake pad is in my hand, and then same thing in that inner part, what is in there, same handling, first in here and then in up, and now it opens. Good. Okay, and now brake pads are away. Okay, and then when I am planning to insert in here those new brake pads, I need to use the specific paste. What is this copper paste? Look, it is brown. It looks like copper. There it come. And this is very excellent lubricant almost all areas in brakes, and especially these moving areas, first this joint, this we can insert in here and pads. And first I press that my copper paste, and we can purchase that copper paste in any car spare part shop, and this cost about €5 or $5 per tube, and there it came, very nice. But use gloves, because this is poison, and then I insert that in that way, and here we must be carefully that we don't insert this copper paste in this brake disc. Be carefully, this is forbidden to use that in here, because this is lubricant. And then I insert also in this upper part, in my finger, carefully, and all that side, and all areas, and look, let's look at that down area, I insert in here, and then same thing in here, down area, that lubricant in here, in down, and then a little bit more, and this up area also. Up area, put this in here. Okay, now I insert in there, and then there is important that there is two bolts in here, these moving bolts, and these bolts must move smoothly. They must be lubricant, and then we take that out so that I only little bit carefully I pull that out in that way, and do not damage this rubber boot. And here is this bolt, and that area we insert also a little bit this copper paste, and then this back installation is easy. I only press that totally deep, and then this boot take contact, and then upper one similar similar process in here. I take that first out. Now it's out, and then lubricant all areas, and this lubrication is, and then I press that in, and now it's ready for chop, cooled, and then we have one next thing. What I need to do is that I need to lubricate also that piston area in here, and this is important that I need to insert in here this copper paste also in that way, and all of these areas I can insert in this copper paste in that area, and also maybe a little bit also this rubber sealant in here, and then when I rotate, there is that side where I need to install also this copper paste. And why I am using this copper paste? Only for that this my brakes works well. Because this copper paste eliminates bad noises in brakes and also corrosion. That this my brakes last longer in good way. Okay, good. Now this my brake system is ready for this brake pads, and then if this copper paste goes in this disc, we take this copper paste immediately away. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and then we have this brake pads lubrication, and now when I am using these old pads, I need to install this my lubricant in here in that side, and also this both noses in that area and that area. And then I can also use this brake paste, what is metal free paste. It is quite similar than this copper paste, but this is only a little bit better this heat resistant. This is even better against heat. And this is similar stuff than copper paste, but only white. And I insert that here both sides, and then I can, and this paste comes only in that other side, not in this side what takes contact to brake disc. This is like braking area, no any lubricant in here, but this other side in that way, and then these heads in here, all areas in here, we need this white stuff in that way. And a little bit more, and here I insert, because this brakes works well, this is fine, and then I insert even in this another pad also in that way. Now, and then I insert this my paste in here, good. And now these pads, they are ready for back installation, and let's go to do that next. Okay, and now when I am planning to insert these new pads, there's one job that I need to compress this piston back in here, and for that job I need big tongs, like in here, and I need to install these tongs so that when there is this area in here, I need to adjust this my tongs so that it takes good grip in that position in here, and second in here in that way. Now when it is in position and there is my hand grip, then I only compress this back. And look, now I am using two hands, and then I compress, and there's, now this piston goes back, and totally in there, good. Now it's in position, and I can install this new patch in there is this patch position, and then I take those pads and here is this first pad and it goes in so that in that way, and this part they contact in here, and I clean this copper paste away, and then I insert that in this side, and these metallic springs, they are flexible, and in that position it's good, and then I only press that in here so easily, and then same thing in this inner brake pad, what is in here, and it comes in that way, and also in here, and this, and we only focus that up, and then this down areas first, and then I rotate that in this way, and then only press in that way, and sometimes we might need this tong. Okay, and then sometimes these pads are tight and we need to compress those, and for that job I use again this my tongs, and I compress, I adjust this my, this is adjustable tong, and I adjust that little bit, and then I press these pads tight together in that way. Now when I compress, there is this my grip, and that way I compress these pads. Okay, good, and now this looks good, and then I take this brake caliper, and this brake caliper goes, let's look in that position, because there is a critical thing, when there are those two bolts in here, that bolt and that bolt, we need to adjust these bolts in that way, that they are in specific place, look, there are two sides, and they must be in same, that they fit in these areas. Let's look at what I do. I insert that this one in here, it comes in that position, and then in here we can see that there is line in here, in that area, and it must fit with that bolt in that way. Now they fit, look. And same in this lower bolt in here, and now when they are in that way, everything is fine, and then I take my bolt, there is my bolt, and it fits in here, and then I only rotate that, and then I take second bolt, and it comes in here, and then if we have difficulties to insert this bolt, it's good to little bit move that caliper in that way, and then when I rotate that more, I can rotate both of these, and there is this upper one. Now this upper one is a little bit tight, it is difficult to rotate, but this lower one, this rotates nicely, but no worry, I need to take only tool, there is this 12mm, 12, 1, 2, and then I continue this my rotation in that way, and I use my hand, and that way, and then it's good to move this caliper all time, this caliper must be really flexible. If we insert this tight in here, then our brakes are stuck. And that's always we need to check that, is this caliper free, and is this moving right? In that way, this movement is really critical and important, because this caliper, it moves in that way, look. This must be checked, and if we have new pads, then this moves only very little bit, but that way. And now I think that because this is so difficult to rotate, I take my tool, wrench, and now I take this my wrench in here, and then I start to use that fast. Put this as well, and then this lower one also. Good. And now this brake pads replaces. Okay, and final step is that when this is moving in that way, is that I need to go in this cabin area, and I need to press this car's brake pedal 20 times that this movement ends, because then this caliper moves in here. And this was this idea that how to replace Honda Civic's front brake pads. Okay, and thank you for watching that video.